Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new and here for the first time. My name is Leah and this is Homeschool at Heart. Today I'm going to be sharing my curriculum picks for the 2023-2024 school year. It is that time of year. I think it's one of the most exciting times of the year, but it can also be one of the most overwhelming times of the year. And so a lot of YouTubers will be showing off their curriculum choices for next year, starting now, so that those of you who need that help can kind of see what some seasoned homeschoolers are kind of going through and choosing for their own families. If you watched my last year video, which I will link in the cards and down below, you will notice that not a ton of things are changing for us because I really felt like we did a good job last year choosing what we were gonna use. So I'm gonna just go ahead and jump in. This year, I'm doing a little bit different. Last year, I did all three of my kids in one video. This year, I'm gonna do one for my going into third grader, one for my fourth grade going into fifth grade, and then one for my almost junior higher. Can you believe that I'm gonna have a junior higher? I can't. So I kind of decided to break that up just so that if people were only looking for a certain age group, like junior high, that they would be able to find that video a little bit easier and not be turned off by the length of it. So we're gonna do, this week will be third grade, next week will be fifth grade, and the following week will be sixth grade. So just in case you're wondering. All right, so also last year, I did not have a Bible curriculum. My kids do Awana at our church and they will continue to do that next year. But I also, was recommended this Bible study to do with my kids, and I think that we're just gonna pick it up as a Bible curriculum for next year. It's not really a curriculum, it's just a family Bible study, but it is in-depth enough that I feel like it deserves a space in our homeschool time. This is from Not Consumed Ministries. This one is called My Brother's Keeper, and we may start it over the summer, I am not sure yet. But I was very excited to get this one. It's called A Biblical Study on Loving Your Siblings. So this is the parent guide. And I am going to be doing this study alongside them. My siblings will probably appreciate it because there are definite things that I will have to do to complete the study. But this one is the primary guide for this. So let me show you what it comes with. So it comes with the little booklet. And then it has a bookmark, and the back of it says, my job is to love, serve, share, forgive, and witness. And it has Bible verses to go with that. It came with stickers, which she will love. And then it came with some challenge cards. So the challenges are things like set up a time every week to pray with your siblings, and it gives some ideas for what to pray for. One more. Challenge two is pick a way to kindly serve a sibling. Ideas are pick up their toys, play a game of their choice, make their bed. And then there's a couple more also because it's a 4-week study. So I'm pretty excited about that. Let me show you what's inside here. So all of them start with, God's creation. So here is kind of what the primary one looks like. I don't want to show too many of the pages, but primary has boxes instead of like just lines, so that if they want to, they can draw pictures instead of write words. I am not entirely sure what she's going to want to do, but here is the parent guide, has how to use this Bible study. And then this is what the pages in the parent guide look like. So obviously I will be able to do much more work than my third grader. So it also comes with stickers in the parent guide. It also comes with the same bookmark. And then I have parent challenges. So challenge week one is set up a time every week to pray for or with your siblings. So same. And then also, I guess they're the same. Pick one way to kindly serve your siblings. So the ideas are different, though. Send them lunch through a delivery service, clean their house, babysit their kids. So my sister will enjoy some of those things. I do also have two brothers, but my sister is the one that probably will get the help. So she has two little babies, and I actually really enjoy spending time with them. So, all right, so that's Bible. So we're going to move on to language arts. So last year I did Moving Beyond the Page with my second grader. She was not reading very well at that point. She is doing so much better now at the end of second grade than she was at the beginning, and that is totally fine. I did have lots of discussions. We homeschool with a charter, had lots of discussion with our teacher facilitator last year about why it was okay for her to not be at what they assume is their grade level for reading. Almost fights, I would say. This year we have a different teacher facilitator, and she has been just marvelous, you guys. So we started out with Moving Beyond the Page. The one that I chose was not awesome, but it was the way that our school works is that they need us to do a certain, they have a list of curriculum that they're allowing us to choose from. It's a pretty extensive list, but there's not a lot on the list that counts for the whole language arts. And if I choose something that is not in the small category that goes over the entire category of language arts, then I have to pull from a whole bunch of things. So right now we're doing a little bit of Moving Beyond the Page because that was like the full curriculum package for language arts. I think there were like maybe one or two others that I didn't love. So I did go ahead though, because I didn't feel like Moving Beyond the Page was appropriate for teaching her to read in the grade level that I ended up going with. It ended up being more social studies and science as opposed to teaching her how to read. So I did bring back in all of that reading, and she was also still doing Explode the Code, which sounds like a lot, but really it only takes us maybe 30 minutes a day to handle all of those things. So it's not that much, but we are going to be doing Moving Beyond the Page to satisfy the requirement for grammar and spelling, so that I don't have to have a separate curriculum for her. So we are going to be using the ages 7 to 9 age group for her. She just turned 8, so she's right in the middle of that age group. So, I only bought though a couple of the guides. So, and the books that go with them, because we're not moving through them really quickly. Moving Beyond the Page is a pretty, it's a pretty rigorous curriculum. And so because we're also doing, all about reading next year as well, I didn't want to overwhelm her. So, I'm only committing to doing a couple of the guides right now because that's all that I bought. So the first one is Tornado, which she's excited about because it's about this cute little dog. So let me tell you what it is like. So here is an example of what, the pages are like inside of this book. Also with this one, I'm not sure how it ties in, but it came with this. How the Turtle Got Its Shell, little golden book. So it's a picture book. And then the guide has discussion questions. And then maps to color in. Here is farm life. Draw a picture of yourself working on a farm. Things like this. So it's not... it's definitely not going to be beyond her. It's going to stretch her a little bit, which is exactly what we want. So we're going to be doing that. Then I also got Sarah Plain and Tall as the next one. So Sarah Plain and Tall is also a very short little novel. So what we're going to be doing is she and I will take turns reading these because I don't want her to be overwhelmed or discouraged. She is reading much better, but she is not quite at this level. So, she's going to be doing these with me. I do all of her schoolwork with her. So just know that. Don't be like, Leah, what are you doing to your kid? She's going to be fine. So she and I will do all about reading together. I have done all about reading with all of my children now. We love this program. It is a very gentle approach to reading. And I already have the teacher's manual and the readers that come with it. So all I had to purchase for next school year is the activity book. So these are just really fun exercises. But you wouldn't think that this would be that big of a help, but it really has helped her this year. So we are going to go into level 3. She is completely ready for level 3 for next year. But level 3 of all about reading does not equal even short novels, just because of how much text is on each page. And I just think that this would be overwhelming for her. So likely I will be reading that to her as a read aloud, and then she and I can work through the workbook pages together. So that's what we're going to be doing for language arts. She may do some more explode the code, but I kind of think that we will be, we'll have plenty to do with these two things. All right. So for math, we are going to continue on with math and focus. She has been doing this one since the beginning. And she's going to be in third grade. She's going to move on to level 3A. And then I also went ahead and got level 3B. I do also have the teacher editions. I did a comparison video with Math and Focus, Saxon, and Right Start Math. And I will link that also below so you guys can kind of go and see what it looks like inside of the Math and Focus books. And kind of see if like one of those curriculums is going to be better for your child for math. And I already have done that one, so I'm not going to do it in this particular video. But so that's what we're doing for math. It is a common core approach to math. And I will say that if I had just jumped in at third grade into common core math, it probably would have been too hard for me. I have been using this curriculum since kindergarten, though, with all of my kids did this curriculum for kindergarten. And then, I think I also did it for first grade for all of them also. But in second grade, I moved into Saxon with my oldest, and then she moved into Right Start Math last year and then has done it this year. And we'll be doing that again next year because Right Start is a different way. It's just a different approach to math. But my littler two did just fine with Common Core Math, so we decided to stick with it. All right, so let's talk about what I consider to be the fun subjects, which are history and science. I really enjoy teaching these classes, so they're my favorite. So here is what we are choosing to do for history for this coming school year, the 2023-2024 year, school year. It's early American history, a literature approach for intermediate grades. So this is third grade through sixth grade from Beautiful Feet Books. So what this is just the guide, and then which my charter school did not pay for, by the way. There must be some Christian material inside of this guide, which I welcome, but they do not. they did allow me to purchase all of the books, though, that go with it, so we're not complaining. The guide, I already actually owned this guide, and it probably only cost around $12. I bought this one used. So we'll be going through books like A Child's First Book of American History. We'll be learning about Vikings, Columbus, Pocahontas, William Bradford, The Landing of the Pilgrims, Benjamin Franklin, Paul Revere, George Washington, and Sacagawea, Lewis and Clark, Abe Lincoln, Harriet Tubman, Sojourner Truth, which my kids will love. We learned a little bit about the both of them this year, but I'm excited to go more on a deep dive. We have more General Washington, Valley Forge, The Boy Who Drew Birds, which is about John James Audubon, which is cool, and The Amazing Impossible Erie Canal. So that is what we're going to be learning about here. And then we are going to continue working through units from Harbor and Sprout for science. So here is the notebook that I'm using to put all of my teacher materials in every month. So I have enjoyed Harbor and Sprout immensely this year. It has been kind of life-changing for us. It has caused us to do more, reading together, that's like cohesive with what we're learning. It has brought new books to my attention because they give like a really great reading list for each unit. It's caused us to do more experiments and just get outside more because we're using it for both science and nature study to make it a more well-rounded science experience for my kids. So they have about 4 lessons for science and 4 lessons for nature study. And we like to do science 2 times a week. So we are doing 1 science, 1 nature study lesson each week. And that is just perfect, the perfect amount for us. And it kind of like gives us a really well-rounded approach of whatever we are learning about. So like, for instance, we are at the tail end of... homesteading. I always want to say home study because we're homeschoolers, but it's homesteading. We're at the end of a homesteading unit and we're learning about food preservation for science and like food mold and things like that. And so we have like this big experiment that's going over the whole time with food mold, and it's really fascinating. And then we're also learning about how to garden well and how to compost and how different plants are used for different things with the nature study part of it. So that has been really eye-opening and really cool. And so we're gonna continue on with that. I think, so this year, we're gonna finish up this year with beekeeping and aviation. And then next year, we're going to start off our studies with botany. They have a program where I can still continue to use one topic to teach all 3 of my children as a family subject. And so that's what we're going to do with history and science is keep them as family subjects as well as Bible. Because I think that that is just such an important part of our homeschool life. Is to stay together. I think, you know, I feel like that's really part of the reason why we are homeschooling right now is because it is really developing that family relationship. And I really, really just love where we're at as a family right now. So that is everything that Charlotte will be doing as far as her core curriculum for next year. I will be going to the homeschool convention in June. So in about 6 weeks, and I'm sure that I'm going to find more things to add, to our morning time, things that might just like bring out, more exciting things from the topics that I know that we're going to be studying. So like for instance, YWAM will be there, Youth with a Mission Publishing, and I always love to gather up a few of their books to go with some of the studies that we'll be doing. So like, for instance, we can do one on George Washington, one on Abraham Lincoln, one on Benjamin Franklin. Those historical figures, we can dive more deeply into the richness of that particular topic. So I will be definitely keeping you guys updated on what things that I get to go alongside of these curriculum choices. But for right now, that's gonna be it. So I will see you guys next week to talk about what we're gonna be doing for my 4th grader. See you then. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. In this video, I'm going to go ahead and show you a little bit of what we did on Easter. We played a really fun game and had a great time just as a family. So I'm going to leave you with that, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.
Uh-oh. Be thankful you don't have hair.
Do it again.